Phylum Echinodermata is classified into two major subphyla. One is called Pelmetazoa, which cannot move around, they are stalked. Of course, some of the forms like feather stars can move around, but most of them included under subphylum Pelmetazoa. They are sedentary, as in they don't move, and they are fixed to a stalk to the bottom of the sea, and therefore they are referred to as the stalked and sedentary echinoderms. In subphylum Pelmetazoa, there is a single class that is referred to as class Crinoidea. The best example for class Crinoidea are sea lilies such as Tilocrinus and Bathycrinus, and of course we have the feather star, which can move around, so not all members are fixed to the bottom of the seafloor. As you can see in the image, they have five radiating arms, and you can see leaf-like structures which are emerging out from the main axis of each arm, and those leaf-like projections are referred to as the pinnules. On the pinnules, you will find rows of tube feet which do not have suckers. So we call such tube feet which do not have suckers, we refer to them as the podia. They do not have a madreporite, and then lastly their larva is referred to as the crinoid larva. Subphylum Eleutherozoa are those which can move around freely. They don't have a stalk. Under that you have class 1, that is Asteroidea. As you know, in Asteroidea, the best representative form is the sea star, whose body is star-shaped with 5 radiating arms. They do have a madreporite on the aboral surface along with the anus, whereas on the oral surface, there is a central 5-angled mouth, as you all know. And this example, the best example is Astropecten, which is the common starfish. The larval stages, they also exhibit indirect development. So it is Bipinnaria and Brachiolaria larva. Another class under subphylum, second subphylum, that is Eleutherozoa, is Ophiuroidea, which are commonly referred to as the brittle stars, because you can notice how they have serpentine arms in their body and they move by quick progression, and therefore sometimes they are also referred to as the serpent stars. And notice that there is a central disc to which these arms are attached, and the arms are very, very fragile. They can break off easily. That's one of the reasons why they are referred to as the brittle star. The larva of these forms is referred to as the Ophiopluteus larva. Then we have the sea urchin. All the sea urchins belong to a group which is referred to as class Echinoidea. They have a globular disc. They have a skeleton actually, which is a test or a tunic, which is globular, which is covered entirely by spines. So basically you can't see the calcareous plates, the skeleton composed of the closely fitted calcareous plates, because it is shrouded by these spines which you see on the outside. And some of these spines are also movable. They have a specialized chewing apparatus or a masticatory apparatus, which is referred to as the Aristotle's lantern, just inner to their mouth, which helps in chewing the food and feeding process, and they are also exhibiting indirect development. The larva of Echinoidea is Echinopluteus larva. The last member under Eleutherozoa is what looks like a cucumber, and that's why it is referred to as a sea cucumber. The scientific name of sea cucumber is Holothuria. The class to which it belongs to is referred to as Holothuroidea. As you can see, the body is very leathery, it doesn't have any spines. It looks like a cucumber, a cylindrical body. There is a distinct mouth and anus. Rather than calling it an anus, we can call it as a cloaca, because it is a common opening for excretory and digestive system. And you can see a lot of tentacles surrounding the mouth. They do not have any arms, and especially in the cloacal region, inside the cloaca, they have a cloacal chamber which bears a branch structure called the respiratory tree. They draw the seawater in through their cloaca, and it passes through the respiratory tree that helps in respiration. The larva of sea cucumber is called as Auricularia larva.